بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Today we are going to talk about pulse oximeter screening in newborn to enhance detection of the critical congenital heart disease. This is requested from two doctors, Dr. Bahá Sheikh and Dr. Mustafa Munir. Seven congenital or critical congenital heart disease. What is the seven critical congenital heart disease we are screened? To memorize it from your heart by simple way, five, it will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. One truncus arteriosus, truncus, one trunk, one trunk, truncus arteriosus. Two, transposition of great arteries, transposition of great arteries, it will be two. Tricuspid atresia, tricuspid atresia. Four, tetralogy of Fallot, tetralogy of Fallot. The fifth, transposition of total anomaly pulmonary venous return. Total anomaly pulmonary venous return. It will be five. So truncus arteriosus, transposition of great arteries, tricuspid atresia, tetralogy of Fallot, and total anomalies pulmonary venous return. This is five. Still two, it will be hypoplastic left heart and pulmonary atresia. This is the seven critical congenital heart disease we are screened for them. Why we need to screen it and who is targeted? Why we are looking for the seven? Why specific for this seven? Because actually some of this congenital or critical congenital heart disease requiring surgery. This is the first. So we are looking for this critical congenital heart disease might need surgery. And the second issues might need cath or cardiac cath, or might need pharmacological intervention like prostaglandin to avoid the death and to avoid the end organ damage. So we have seven critical congenital heart disease. We are screened for them. Why? Because might need intervention or surgical intervention or cardiac cath or pharmacological management. Why? To avoid the death and mortality and morbidity and end organ damage. How to screen? You have three ways to screen: antenatally and postnatally. Antenatal by fetal ultrasound or fetal echo, you will detect almost 85% from the cases. Postnatally, it will depend on clinical and pulse oximeter. By clinical tools, you have to assess cardiac examination, inspection, palpation, percussions, and by pulse oximeter, simple and non-invasive. Clinical presentation and missing keys. Actually, we are screening asymptomatic patient after 24 hours. Sometimes this patient actually will discharge, and because there is false positive, false negative of the test, and he will present it to you actually by 2C and 2S, shock, syncope, or cyanosis, or congestive heart failure. Who will present it with you with shock, coarctation of the aorta, and hypoplastic left heart. The timing, the hypoplastic left heart, it will be in the first and second day of life, and coarctation of the aorta or interrupted aortic arch, it will present it in the first and second week of life. Who will present with cyanosis? Transposition great artery and tetralogy of Fallot. Who will present with heart failure? It will be large left to right shunt. So 2S and 2C. 2S shock and syncopal attack. The syncopal attack would be aortic stenosis and pulmonary stenosis, obstructive lesions. And who will present it with shock, coarctation, and hypoplastic heart? Cyanosis will be transposition of great artery and tetralogy of Fallot. Congestive heart failure, it will be left to right shunt. It will be tachycardia and tachypnea and tender liver 3T. How to screen? By pulse oximeter. Why pulse oximeter? Simple, painless, non-invasive. Actually, pulse oximetry application very simple and painless, non-invasive. So this is will be better screening. Then you have to estimate the percentage of the hemoglobin in the blood that is saturated with the oxygen. This is how the screening is detect, or how to detect the cyanotic heart disease or critical congenital heart disease. Pulse oximeter reading taken on the right hand because the periductal and lower limb or the foot, whatever, right or left. But the most important, it will be the right hand, because this is a preductal and postductal, it will be down. Reading values, I have to compare it to standard algorithm, either the American Academy or American Heart Association. Detection rate, if I'm detected the screened or detect of the congenital or critical congenital heart disease by pulse oximeter and clinical examination, the detection rate will be higher. And also, detection rate will be higher and will decrease the false positive and false negative, and the sensitivity and the specificity, it will be higher, and positive predictive value and negative predictive value, it will be better than you are screened by pulse oximeter alone or by clinical examination alone. If you combine the pulse oximeter and the clinical examination together, the detection rate, it will be higher and will decrease the false positive and false negative. This is how to screen. This is the practical tips. Actually, it here, it will be, this is the preductal. You see here, this is the preductal. It will be in the right hand, and the postductal, it will be in the foot, whatever, left or right. Practical tips. This is the most important practical tips during you are screening for critical congenital heart disease. The patient should be asymptomatic newborn and well nursery, and should be more than 24 hours off age. I have to use a new generation pulse oximeter. I have to use good one, not used one or bad one. The second, actually, I have to both single or use or reusable probe acceptable. The probe you are using in the pulse oximeter, either single use or reusable based on your resources and your condition and your hospital and your institutions. And you have to use two sides, the right hand as pulse oximeter and the lower limb, whatever, right or left, as postductal, preductal and postductal. The result, any values less than 90% is abnormal. This is not pass or negative test. Less than 90, above 95, this is mean the pass the test. Between 90 to 95, actually, you have to repeat after 1 hour. If still, you have to repeat it after 2 hours. You have to have three reading to confirm this patient actually is pass or not pass. Here, this is the flow chart. This is the algorithm. This is very important. Actually, we have a lot of algorithms. There is American algorithm or CDC, and another one is UK. The difference between the UK and the American or the Canadian, it's depend actually, one, it's less than 90 in the right and the foot. Actually, this is, it will not pass. If more than 95, actually, it will be pass. The in between 90 to 95, and the difference between 3% between the preductal and postductal, this is the American. But the UK, it will be 90 to 94. 90 to, even the bust, it will be more than 94. That's just only the 1% of the saturation. This is to differentiate between this screen is come from the American and Canadian, or this screen is come from the UK. But for sure, we are full. We are actually in our screening. We are following the American guideline or Canadian guideline. This is the American guideline or the CDC guideline. We'll see how to do the screen. Simple and easy screened. Actually, simple and easy. If you see here, I will make it magnified. This one, the child should be well asymptomatic, more than 24 hours of age, or shortly before discharge if less than 24 hours of age. I will started my screening. You see here, I will started my screening. First of all, I have to, this is the 90, if you goes here, this is 90, here. This is, if the baby, after I put the pulse oximeter in the right hand and the foot, and there is less than 90, the screening is less than 90, this means this patient is failed the screen. This is failed the screen. This patient failed the screen. We'll go for the other one is the, if more than, you see here, more than 90, you see here, more than 90 in the right hand, or the foot, and the difference less than 3% between the right hand and the foot, this is pass the test. and this is pass the test, and this is pass, this is normal, and you have to discharge this patient. The problem, it will be here, in the middle. The problem, it will be here, between 90 and 95. You see here, between 90 and 95. In the right hand and foot, and the difference, it will be more than 3% difference between the right hand and foot. What we are going to do with this age group, or the difference is more than 3% and between 90 and less than 95, I have to screen it again. I have to repeat it after 1 hour. I have to repeat after 1 hour. It will give me the same reading, less than 90, less than 90 in the right hand and or the foot. This means he's not passed the test, not passing the test here. If you see here, this is 9. If you goes here, you see here, this is less than 90. So this is not pass. If I goes here again, here, you see here, this is more than 90 in the right hand or the foot, and less than 30, the difference between the preductal and postductal in the right hand and the foot, this is one is pass the test. Again, the problem with that in the middle, between 90 and less than 95 in the right hand and the foot, and the difference more than 3 between the right hand and the foot, or preductal and postductal. So this is the group 90 and less than 95, and the difference between the preductal and postductal more than 3, I have to repeat for the second time. I have to repeat it again after 1 hour for the second time. You see, I have to repeat it here for the second time. We have only 3 reading, either less than 90 or more than 95, and the difference less than 3%. If less than 90, this is failed. If more than 95, and the difference less than 3% between the preductal and postductal, this means he passed the test. Still, between 90 and less than 95 in the right hand and the foot, and the difference is more than 3 between the right hand and the foot, or the preductal and postductal, this is failed screening. So in the between, I have to do 3 times. I have to do it 3 times, 1 hour apart. If less than still between 90 and less than 95, and there is a difference is more than 3% between the preductal and postductal, I have to label this patient is not pass the test, and I will go for other test, for confirmatory test, or I will call the neurologist or the cardiologist. This is the UK. This is UK. You see, very nice. Why very nice? Because green and red and yellow. Like traffic signal, traffic signal, إشارات المرور, traffic signal. If you see the green, this means he pass. The red, this means he's not pass. In the middle, it will be the yellow. In the middle, it will be yellow. We'll see. But here, this is the UK guideline. This is the UK. You have to check the oxygen saturations in the right hand and either the foot rift or light all neonate between 24 to 36. You see the American more than 24 or just close to the 24. The UK is more restricted actually. It will be between 24 to 36 hours of age. We'll see the test here. If the patient, if you see here 90 by red here, if you see here, this is less than 90. Less than 90 in the right hand or the foot, this is mean abnormal. This is less than 90, this abnormal, and he will say not pass the test. This failed screening, you have to call most responsible for the health care provider. This failed, you have to call for help, and you have to call the most responsible for the health care provider, and to make it the clinical assessment and the more accurate test, if you need echo, ECG, and all this. If you will go for the green here, if you go for the green here, you see the greens, the green here, the green, you see the green, more than 95, or foot, and less than 30% difference between right hand and foot is normal. This is pass the test. More than 90, and the difference less than 3 between the preductal and postductal, this is pass the test. So, less than 90, the preductal and postductal, this is not pass the test, and they have to evaluate. more than 95 and the difference between the preductal and postductal less than 3%, he passed the test. This is green. خلاص he passed the test. The problem in between. This is the yellow. The problem here in the yellow. Between 90 and 94. You see here. Between 90 and 94. The preductal and postductal and or the difference actually. If the difference more or the difference more than 3% between the preductal and postductal, I have to repeat the test again. You see, I have to repeat the test after 1 hour. I have to repeat. You see, I have to repeat the test after 1 hour. The result is three results. Less than 90, you not pass the test. More than 95 and the difference less than 3%, this is actually he passed the test. Green, he passed the test. Less than 90, he didn't pass the test or failed the test. I have to evaluate him. Between again 90 to 94 right hand and foot, or more than 3% difference between the preductal and postductal, I have to repeat the test for the third time after 1 hour. Again, I have three results. Less than 90, the preductal and postductal, I have to evaluate and assess. This is failed the test because red, this is red. If more than 95 preductal and postductal and less than 30% difference between the right hand and foot, this is normal, this is pass the test. Again, in the middle, this is the yellow. It will be between 90 to 94 in right hand and foot, or the difference between the preductal and postductal more than 3%. What are going to do this? This patient is failed. You consider is failed. Consider this patient failed the test. I have to call the most responsible healthcare provider to check this patient and evaluate this patient. This is another guidelines also. This one 90-94 again, and less than 90 or more than 90. You see, it's very simple, actually very simple. You see, green and red and yellow. The if the patient more than 95 and the difference actually if less than 3, also I have, this is pass. If the less than 90, this is not pass. It's between 90 to 94. Actually I have to repeat after 1 hour. Then if still I have to repeat after another 1 hour, if still the difference is more than 3 or still between 90 and 94, this one I have to this is failed the test. I have to evaluate this baby. I have to evaluate this baby. So after I finish the screening, babies less than 90, this is failed. I have to send him for further evaluation and confirmatory test and to be evaluated by neurologist and cardiologist, or more than 95 and the difference less than 3%. This is pass the test. I have to discharge this one. The problem with the 90 to 90, you see here. If here, you see here, between 90 and less than 95. Between 90, because I am following the American guidelines, the CDC guideline, between 90 and less than 95 in the right hand and foot, and the difference more than 3%, the difference more than 3% preductal and postductal, this one, what I have to repeat it, I have to repeat after 1 hour for two sessions. If still the baby between 90 and less than 95, or the difference more than 3%, so this patient need actually to place on the EEG and they have to transfer to NICU. You have to admit to NICU and you have to place it in EEG monitoring, and you have to assist by neurologist or nurse practitioners, and also you have to consult for cardiologist for evaluation. You have to call cardiologist for evaluation. So the conclusion, baby failed the screening and the oxygen saturation less than 90 preductal postductal, or the baby three times less than 95 and the difference between preductal and postductal more than 3 point or the 3%. So the first thing what are going to do, confirm the accuracy of the reading. This is the first. Second, if the baby less than 24 hours, I have to call him to, I have to repeat the test after 24 hours, looking for the accuracy and confirmatory test. The third, I have to make it additional clinical evaluation to assess for non-cyanotic or non-cardiac causes. The fourth, I have to do echo and transfer the patient for facilities with cardiologists is there and the echo is there. So any reading less than 90 or the patient between the reading between 90 and less than 95 and the difference more than 3%, I have to do four things. The first, confirmatory accuracy of the reading. If the patient actually I screen it less than 24 hours, I have to repeat it after 24 hours for more accuracy. The third one, I have to do additional clinical evaluation to assess for non-cardiac causes. And the fourth, I have to do echo and evaluate it by cardiologist. I have to evaluate it by cardiologist. Home message. Critical congenital heart disease causes significant morbidity and morbidity. Actually, if you missed these cases of critical congenital heart disease, more morbidity and more mortalities and poor outcomes. So, should newborn screen for critical congenital heart disease with pulse oximeter? It will be simple, non-invasive, and painful, and promising actually. Physical examination is still useful. Still useful also. Physical examination is still useful and not depend on the pulse oximeter. It's okay, he will detect more than 85 or 95. It's okay. No, still the physical examination is still useful, because if you combined the pulse oximeter and the physical examinations, it actually the detection rate will be higher and will decrease the false positive and false negative. Early diagnosis of critical congenital heart disease may improve the outcome. Early detection will improve the outcome. Guideline for implementation of the screening have been defined. You have each unit, each institution, each hospital should implement guideline for screening. Why we need this one? To avoid the mortality and morbidity, to improve the outcome. And actually some babies need early intervention by cardiac surgery or cath, or actually you need to start pharmacological management of prostaglandin until to transfer the patient for cath or cardiac surgery. Future refinements, it's likely actually, and the pulse oximeter screening for critical congenital heart disease is coming. So actually, this for the hospital is not applying. Actually, this talking about the people is not applying the screening. Any hospital not applying the screening, please. Actually, you have to apply it. It will avoid a lot of mortality, morbidity, early detection, improve the outcome, decrease the burden for the parents, also decrease the cost effective, actually decrease the deaths and the end organ damage. ومن أحياها فكأنما أحيا الناس جميعا. At the end, I would like to pray for my colleague is going for the exam, Arab board, Saudi board, and Jordanian and Egyptian board, and my colleagues for neonatal fellowship. أسأل الله رب العرش العظيم أن ينجح كل زملائنا داخلين اختبارات. شكرا, سلام عليكم.